Hey YouTube, here is a video about resurfacing the spoil board for the Biesse Rover 24. Here is our spoil board, and occasionally we get some deep grooves because tooling isn't set right or the tool holders are not measured properly, and that's all my fault because I should know all that stuff. But occasionally too we have to cut a little deeper because of the material, a plastic edge. We get a better edge if we cut a little bit deeper, and that's actually what all these are. This is a new bit that I haven't used before, a new style bit. It's an O-Flute, half inch O-Flute, and I wasn't quite sure. We got some fantastic cuts out of it, but I ruined the spoil board in the process. So I'm going to go ahead and redo this spoil board, and the bit I'm going to use, it's a huge bit. Let me move this over. I'm going to go to manual movement. And then I've already homed the machine and run a warm-up. I'm going to go down here and I'm going to push. If I push just this, it's going to move in the x-axis. So it's going to move the whole machine. So you see like that. I don't know if you can see it moving. If I push this button and this, so I push this first and then this, watch what happens. It's a quick move. So, but I want to bring the head closer to me, so I want to move it in the Y axis. So I'm going to go ahead and do the same thing. All I did here was I clicked on this. You can pick from either X, Y, Z, or the tool cradle. I'm going to pick Y. I'm going to push this and this. I'm going to push this and this with, well, we're looking at the machine. I'm going to bring it to just about there, and then I'll show you the tool we're going to use here. It's way in the back, so I'm going to do a manual movement of the cradle, and again I'm going to come down here and push the plus. If I just push the plus, it goes like that fast. If I push the squiggly line in the plus, it goes the same speed. So I'm going to bring it all the way around twice so I can show you this bit that I'm using. This is the surfacing, I think it's an 70 or 80 millimeter, not quite sure. It should say up there, but anyway, so that's what it is. I'm going to put it back in here. As long as I'm in manual movement, I need to set the spoil board as if it were thinner. So I go down here, and my soft key for the spoil board is right here. So I'm going to push this and watch. As I push this, the spoil board window will pop up. And as I do that, the jig thickness is the spoil board. I'm going to change this to 16.5. I'm going to go down 2.5 millimeters. So I'm going to take a full 2.5 millimeters off, which is pretty drastic. But the spoil board is pretty deep there. All right, we're going to do that. I'm going to click this. Now I'm going to click back on automatic. And I'm going to select my surfacing program, which I have it surface X axis. And you have to just write a program that'll go all the way across back and forth with a little bit of overlap in order to re-level the table. Then now we do our standard soft key down here, start. Program is loaded. I'm gonna come down here and push my number one quadrant on my pedestal. I do wanna suck down, so I've turned on the compressor vacuum pump, and now I gotta open up the pump to the table. And if I'll try and get this as I hit this, watch right here, it'll suck it down. See it suck it down? that opens up that valve, and now I push this button again. Occasionally I have to run this a few times just to get the right depth. Let's see if this pass takes off those grooves. Looks pretty good. I'm gonna turn on my vacuum pump, my exhaust. It's right at the bottom. That should be great. All right, and then I'll zoom back to the back corner. I'm going to take this out of the computer's thought process. See, there's a program running. I hit stop, clear, reset, and now I've got my logo again. Now I can walk over to the table and see what I got. Yeah, it's pretty good. I mean, this, I'm not gonna resurface this. It's tight enough that it'll not lose a lot of air off the side, and we should get a good bite we should get a good pull for the tools. All right, thanks YouTube. Please like this video and share it with anyone that you think it might be useful and helpful to, and if you subscribe to the channel, I'll be carrying on with more CNC work to help people in the community to get a better product. So, all right, comment in the bottom if you have anything that you need help with, and I'm happy to try and help. Thanks much, and take care.